everyone. This video will cover an overview of Microsoft Windows 10. Microsoft Windows 11 was released recently, but Microsoft Windows 10 will be supported by Microsoft till October 14th of 2025. This date is when Microsoft will stop releasing security updates to Windows 10 that will keep you safer and more secure online. Since many people still have Windows 10, I thought I would spend a video covering an overview of Windows 10 and its features. We will have a video at a later time that will show how to upgrade to Windows 11, the newest release from Microsoft. First, I want to show you the Start menu. The Start menu can be accessed by clicking on the little window icon. Here, you will see along the left-hand side your account name, and if you click on that, it will allow you to change account settings. You can lock the computer screen, which basically means that you can lock the screen so that it will require a password to get back on. This would be really good if you have young children and you want to lock the screen so that they don't mess up anything that you're working on, or if you're at work. You can also use this feature to lock your screen as well to keep your work secure, because it will prompt a password for you to put in the password once you come back to your computer. The sign out option will allow you to log off the computer. It won't shut off the computer, but it will sign it out. So basically it will just sign out your account, but leave the computer on. Then we can see that there are shortcuts that you can click on that will access different folders. For instance, if I click on Documents, it will open up my Documents folder. If I were to click on Pictures, it would open my Pictures folder. And Settings would open up the Settings dialog box, which allows me to go in and set all sorts of settings. We will cover this in a different video, more in depth. So I'll go ahead and I'll exit that, and I'll go back to the Start menu. Then next, we have the Power option, which will basically allow you to tell the computer or laptop to sleep. It just will help save power if you're walking away from the computer. Shutdown will completely shut off the computer. Restart will restart the computer. So if you're having weird issues with your computer, a lot of times computer technicians, one of the first things they'll tell people is to restart their computer, because that will fix a lot of problems. If you're having some really strange off-the-wall issues, a good thing to start with is maybe restarting your computer. Then we can also see a list of applications, any recently used applications it'll put at the top. Then it will go through and list alphabetically all sorts of different applications. If there is a particular application that you want to put over in the tile section for easy access, you can right-click it, and then a little menu will come up and you can say pin to start. And basically this will pin it over to the tile section right here. And you can actually click on this tile and move it around. You can move around any of these tiles. If there's a tile that you want to get rid of, you can actually, again, right-click it and then click unpin from start, and it will actually disappear. And you can move and organize these tiles however you like, which will allow you to more easily find any kind of programs or applications that you're trying to access. Then we will come to the search section, where you can actually search for an application that you're looking for. For instance, if I was searching for Microsoft Word, I could just type in Word, it will bring it up. I can hit enter on my keyboard to open up Microsoft Word, or I can just go up here and click on it and it will open it for me. So if I'm searching for a file or a program, it's just really easiest to just type it in the search, and then it will bring up either whatever file I'm looking for or application. This little circle here allows you to set up Cortana, which basically allows you to control your computer with your voice. The task view will just bring up all the different applications that you have open, and it will bring it up in a timeline-like view. If you click on File Explorer, it'll bring up File Explorer, and it will allow you to go into your desktop, which will allow you to access anything that you have saved on your desktop. You can click on Downloads, which will show any kind of files that you have downloaded into your Downloads folder. If you have any documents saved in the Documents folder, you can look here for them. or if you have any pictures, this is the first place to look. Music and videos, which is pretty self-explanatory there. OneDrive is Microsoft's online storage. So if you have OneDrive set up and you're signed into your Microsoft account on your computer, you can then browse in OneDrive. So that's a brief overview of File Explorer. Along this taskbar right here, which is what we call this, you can see any applications that you've added to the taskbar. You can click and open kind of application from here as well. If you want to add any applications to the taskbar, you can search for the application. I'll search for PowerPoint because it's not on there yet. I can right click here and click pin to taskbar, and it will add PowerPoint to my taskbar right here. As we go further along, we can see the weather, which is kind of nice. We can also see where it gives me the option to upgrade to Windows 11. We'll make a video later about that. You can also view your battery, how much battery you have left. Next to the battery icon is the wireless icon, which will allow you to see if you're connected to your wireless. You can click the speaker icon, which will allow you to adjust the volume. And then Windows Ink Workspace, this is something that is mostly used with any kind of laptop that allows you to write on the screen with a stylus. So you may see that there. And then way over here, we'll see the notification panel. So if I click on that, it will bring up all the different notification information. If you're working at night and your eyes are getting kind of strained, you can click on Nightlight, which will just warm up the screen a little bit, so it's a little less harsh on your eyes. I'll go ahead and turn that back off. And then finally, we just see the desktop right here, which if you have any files or any programs on your desktop, you'll see them on this picture right here. So this is just a real brief overview of Windows 10. We'll go into some more detail in some later videos for Windows 10, but I just wanted to kind of give just a brief coverage of how to navigate Windows 10. If you have any questions, you can comment in the comments section, and I invite you to subscribe and like this video if you like it. So thank you very much, and have a very, very nice day. Thank you.